Good morning, one and all. Introducing myself, my name is Dhanya Sudarshan, Assistant Department from the Department of Computer Science. The topic for today's discussion is automation in the world of AI, machine learning and data science. Actually, the talk was based on the FDPP agenda on November 8, 2019. Along with me, Vedo Sir from Interview Department, Dhanya Ma'am from EC Department, Minnie Miss from Civil Department, and Dhanya Ma'am from EC Department will release to attend the same. So, before directly going into the topics, actually, I would like to thank Vedo Sir and Raja Sir for mentoring the gaps in my understanding. I will try my level best to convey my understanding to all. So, let's have a humble start. Before directly going to the, actually the FDP was based on familiarizing the Microsoft Azure technology, which was a cloud-based automation platform for automation applications. It was an infrastructure-based platform. So the FDP was intended to familiarize the Microsoft Azure technology that TCS is currently using. So directly going to the Azure, I would like to introduce the area of artificial intelligence, machine learning, and data science, because we are having faculties from all these segments. As you all know, there has been a lot of hype around data in the past few decades, and AI was a hot topic for research in the last years. And actually, AI, the meaning tries to change with every era. So I like to introduce what is AI, machine learning and data science. Then we'll see the impact of automation industry and comes to familiarize with Microsoft Azure. Then the services the Azure is providing and some case studies based on that. So familiarizing the area, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning and data science. As I told you, Microsoft Azure is a technology for automating all these technologies. So before directly going to the Microsoft Azure, I would like to familiarize these basic terms. So from a computer science perspective, I can explain artificial intelligence, deep learning as a subset of machine learning, and machine learning as a subset of artificial intelligence. But I would like to explain in much more simpler terms. What is intelligence actually? As Webster's Dictionary coin says, intelligence is something which is the ability to comprehend, learn, and benefit out of the learning experience. Intelligence is nothing but comprehend, ability to comprehend, learn, and benefit out of this intelligence. So artificial intelligence is nothing but applying this intelligence to a machine. A machine, make the machine intelligent. I would like to explain the simple example. This is a pen, and tip of the pen, we know it's sharp. Okay, tip of the pen is sharp, and when you're trying to touch the tip of a safety pin, it is more sharper. Okay, so while touching the tip of the pen, it is not going to hurt you. And when you're trying to touch the tip of a safety pin, it is going to hurt you. So that is what is experience we are getting. So after experiencing, we came up with the knowledge that the tip of the pen is not going to hurt you anymore, but the tip of a safety pin is going to hurt you. That is experience. I'm talking about intelligence. So this is experience, and I told you like intelligence is nothing but this learning. Learning from this experience and benefiting out of this. So how we are going to benefit out of this intelligence? This is not going to hurt you, that's your experience. The safety pin is going to hurt you, that's another experience. And this is the learning. And how we are benefiting? We are not going to touch the tip of the pin anymore. The same way when we are going to touch a fire, we are not going to touch it again, because you know it is, the information can be passed from somebody, or we can directly gain that experience from touching a fire. So this is the benefit we are getting out of this learning experience. So what artificial intelligence is, we are trying to make the machine gain this intelligence and perform based on this intelligence. So when I was in BTech, I thought this artificial intelligence is all about robotics. Many of you might have thought about saying, I have a notion like artificial intelligence was all about robotics. It is actually true, but it is not fully true. Because artificial intelligence is a broader area, we are having lot many applications coming in the field of artificial intelligence, like this rule-based reasoning, machine vision, speech, break artificial intelligence research, and robotics is just a sub area. So artificial intelligence has a lot more to do. So this is the this is a major perspective. So artificial intelligence is nothing but making the machine gain the intelligence from its experience from the outside world, and it can produce action. So from this learning experience, it is giving us action. So this is artificial intelligence. And as I told you, this machine learning is a subset of this artificial intelligence. Actually, machine learning provides automated tools or statistical tools for implementing this artificial intelligence. It gives us supporting tools for implementing the concept of artificial intelligence. And finally, deep learning is a subset of machine learning. It is something which tries to mimic the human brain. How our human brain is working, the same pattern we are going to mimic in the case of a deep learning network. So we can see our neurons, we receive input from the outside world through our sense organs like eyes, ears, mouth and tongue. We receive impulses from the environment through sense organs. Same way the concept of neural network is working. We are receiving input from the outside world, and based on the inputs, we are assigning weights and the particular decision as making. So your deep learning network is nothing but it's trying to simulate the same concept of human brain. And I cannot say like this data science is a subset of anything. It is having an intersection with artificial intelligence, but we cannot tell it is a subset of something. So data science is nothing but from this learning experience, we are getting some insights. We are getting some insights from this learning experience. We are coming up with some conclusions based on the learning experience. So these are the main terms I would like to just familiarize. So simply saying, artificial intelligence produce actions. So from the learning experience, we are producing actions. So we are doing something based on the learning. Okay, we are beginning out of this learning, we are doing some actions. So simply saying, artificial intelligence produce actions. Same way, machine learning produce predictions. And likewise, data science produce insights. So simply we can explain artificial intelligence, machine learning and data science in these three terms. And one more technology, I know most of you will be quite familiar with this because I am trying to familiarize this Microsoft Azure. I would like to have an introduction or a basic, I would like to give a basic understanding on this basic area. So cloud computing is nothing but is on-demand availability of computer system. Actually, we don't have to order anything. We can just get it or rent it from outside. We can just use the services provided by an outside vendor by paying. This is what is known as cloud computing. So we don't need to have anything in our hand. It can be drained from a cloud. It can be drawn from a cloud. That's the concept of cloud computing. So in 1980, the development of computer starts. Then the second wave started in 2000. Actually, the concept of cloud computing emerged in 2020 and it is still fledged in 2019. This is the evolution of cloud computing. Now I would like to come to the main topic, that is automation impact. This is what the TCS started with. Automation impact is nothing but the impact of automation in industry. By 2025, Gartner, as you all know, it's the world famous number one research company. As per their claim, by 2025, 50% of the data scientist activities will get automated. Industry is going to have 50% automation by 2025 as per the prediction of Gartner. And 2023, the need of IT specialists will get reduced by 20%. So what they are trying to tell us, industry is fast moving. Actually, automation is going to rule the world by 2025. Or the 50% is data will be data scientists to be automated. Data scientists fast will get automated. So there's AI professionals, so the data scientists will become the most attractive profession in the year of 2025. So the problem is like intelligent automation has radically changed the way the organization is moving. Key questions which drive the industry towards the automation. So automation, as I know, as I told you, all these tasks are automating, and the main competition the industry is facing is how can the company stand out? and how they get ahead of their competitors. And so the main issue the company is facing is the clients, huge demands from the client side is happening, and industry cannot move that fast or deliver the services because they need to write 10,000, 20,000 lines of code for a single application demand from a client side, and the client is not ready to wait that long. So that's the main issue. I think I'm able to convey that's the main issue the industry is facing. That other than going for automation, the industry doesn't have any other choice because the huge demand from the client side is happening, and the industry has to develop a fast solution for this client side problems because they are not going to wait for a client to write. Sorry, the industry to train a employee to write or get trained in this technology and finally produce a code which is having 20,000 lines. So industry, other clients are not ready to wait that long. So they want some of the. So the industry has to be more forcefully into the world of automation. That is going to happen. So these are the key questions which drives this automation. How the companies stand out, because they should meet the client demands at a time. Otherwise, they are going to put back. So how to move ahead the competitor, and how they can quickly develop solutions for the client. And what they are telling, like the employees or our students has to be trained in some order because they are not providing much time for training because the client needs quick and fast solution for problems. So previously they were spending 2-3 months for this training, and as of now they don't have that much time for training. So because the demand from clients is increasing, quick and fast output they have to deliver. So what they suggest is we can train our students to this. Actually, TCS uses these Microsoft ML services and Google ML or technology that massively support this acceleration. So TCS is using Microsoft Azure service for this automation. TCS has already moved to the automation platform. They are using the service of Microsoft Azure for this automation purpose. We have similar Google Auto ML etc. for supporting the same application. So what they are telling is they are using the Microsoft Azure technology for moving to the world of automation. So Microsoft Azure is a cloud computing service. It's a cloud-based service and created by Microsoft. So the security aspects, everything will be taken care of Microsoft because we all trust Microsoft. And building, testing, deploying and managing application service through Microsoft managed data centers. So TCS is fully relying on this Microsoft Azure for automating that process. So it is nothing but a cloud computing platform for automating the service. Actually, they familiarized, the session was entirely for familiarizing. It was a one-day session, one-day family development program. It was entirely for familiarizing this Microsoft Azure technology. So they explained the cognitive services offered. Cognitive service is nothing but AI for everyone. Normal citizen who is having a basic knowledge of AI, they can use this service as it because they have already given the links and all we are checking. If the documentation is crystal clear, like we can implement through all the process. Only thing is that we have to set up an account. It is paid only. This is the main revenue source for Microsoft. It is a paid only. It is not an open source. So we can pay and create a. Initially, they are giving a 1 month trial version for familiarization. After that, they are charging for that. So we can create an account in Microsoft Azure to use the services rapidly. The advantage is like before we are going for 20,000, 30,000 lines of code, now we are able to replace it with a 4 or 5 lines of Python code. That's the advantage. Initially we were writing 20,000, 30,000 lines of code, we are able to compress it to 4 or 5 lines of Python code. They are providing APIs, that is application program interfaces and SDKs, which is software development kits, to support the same. And they're providing quick and fast machine learning solutions. Actually, I'm not here to market the Microsoft Azure, I'm just familiarizing the concept to you. Same, likewise, TCS is actually, IBM is offering IBM Watson services. So each industry has their own selection and they are going for the services accordingly. So these are the cognitive services supported by. Cognitive is nothing but the reading offers by the APIs. It is supporting decision making tasks for, then it is supporting language tasks for search, for text to speech conversion, speech to text conversion, then vision for recognizing faces, etc. So all these kinds of application, the API is supported by the Microsoft Azure. For each and every, I don't think I need to explain each and every because everything is familiar. My computer vision, custom vision, face recognition, ink recognizer, which is in a document, then video index. There are not many services, and we are having links to each. So in this link, if you are clicking on this link, we can see how to execute the thing from a normal. I'm not telling from a computer science perspective. From anyone of you can just create an account. You can use the service because the documentation is that clear. So, if provided, I can share this link, so these links are accessible. It is supporting decision-making services, it is supporting language services, it is supporting web search services like Bing, spell check, etc. So, what I am trying to tell us, this automation or the introduction of this Microsoft Azure drastically changes the legacy way of processing. So, initially, for just to extract the text, we have to go through these many steps. And by using this automated technology, we are able to compress this to a few steps. Because here our API comes, and API does the entire process, and finally the user gets the converted output. So we are easily able to reduce the steps from the legacy way of doing. Then Azure offers a set of machine learning services like. Machine learning, we know, we have a training set, we have a testing set. So, from a computer science perspective, everybody will be clearly knowing how the operation of how this machine learning activities works. So, in the Azure, they are providing all the options for importing data, training data, testing data. So, we can simply add our data to get the output. We don't have, actually, I'm going to tell you, like, there are so many open sources Python code, so you can easily use that without paying. I need to mention that also in between because these are not paid versions, but the paid versions is having its own securities. Yes. Then it is supporting, Azure is supporting data science tasks too. Data science have already familiarized what is meant by data science to infer conclusion from documents, infer conclusion from this learning. I can tell you an example, like for data science tech, I can tell you an example. We were able to sort mails to different categories like promotion mails, spam mails. So those are examples for data science tasks. By reading the text or reading the content, we are able to come up with some inferences. Okay, by reading a mail, we can easily, or the system, or the intelligence system is easily able to tell like whether it is spam mail or a promotion mail or it's a normal inbox mail. This is supposed to stay in the inbox. So these kind of inferences, deriving these kind of inferences, we'll call it as data science tasks. And this Azure is supporting all the needed support for this data science tasks, executing this data science task. I'll just tell Azure is also offering a containerization services. Containerization is nothing but the TCS or in any company platform, they are developing services from their side. They are performing the client sends the requirement, they are developing applications in their side, and they have to containerize it in a single capsule and get implemented in the client side. Okay, the client will be sending request and the industry has to perform it with a minimum span of time with the help of Azure, and the industry should be able to deploy it in the client side also. Okay, so containerization is nothing but a set of services for supporting the same. For developing the applications in the industry perspective, they are developing and they are containing or they are capsulizing it and deploying it in the industry, deploying it to the client side. So, containerization, we have two main categories. One is Docker. Docker is build, ship, and run anywhere. It is just a capsule, it's providing a capsule or a set of services to containerize the service delivered by the company. So, that is Docker. And Kubernetes is nothing but to supporting services to deploy it in the client side. So, both are not same. Docker and Kubernetes both are complementary to each other. Docker provides an open standard for packing and distributing containerized application. Docker provides an open standard for packing, while Kubernetes provide an infrastructure need to deploy it in the client side. So, I know it's not clear. Actually, this is just a case study. These are the companies currently doing research in the field of artificial intelligence. This is the latest update by 2019 version. I know by 2020, I cannot compress this in a single slide. So I would like to convey the information like these many companies in the field of infrastructure, in the field of analytics, in the field of application enterprise. You can see Uber, Oracle, all the companies, all the applications we are using currently participate in the AI research. So AI is the hot area of research we already know. So this is the importance. These many companies are, this is a case study, and these many companies are currently doing research in the field of artificial intelligence. It's not clear because I need to include it in a single slide, because then only you get an impact like these many companies are currently doing research in the field of artificial intelligence. So with this, I'm concluding my sessions.